Football on BTN is presented by Speedway. And today, the Wisconsin Badgers travel to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln to take on the Nebraska Cornhuskers. A lot to play for today for the Wisconsin Badgers. You see, they still harbor hopes of representing the West in Indianapolis in the Big Ten Championship game. They'll be rooting today for the Iowa Hawkeyes to knock off Minnesota. And then they've got the Gophers in the final game of the year in just a couple of weeks. Wisconsin with plenty on the line as they travel west to Lincoln, Nebraska today. Husker fans getting ready for Nebraska to enter the field with the traditional tunnel walk here in Lincoln. Nebraska today's consecutive sellout streak continues. That number will soon change to 375 consecutive sellouts, an ongoing NCAA record. And here come the Huskers, led by Scott Frost, who got a two-year contract extension earlier today, extending his contract back out for a full 7 years. One of seven programs with 900 wins, Nebraska fans are hoping that they can find a little bit of a turnaround today and get an upset over a top 20 foe in Wisconsin. Huskers take the field, but a tough task today as their opposition from Madison, Wisconsin, the Wisconsin Badgers, make their way out at Memorial Stadium. Today, as we welcome you into the booth alongside Matt Millen, I'm Kevin Kugler. So with Wisconsin still hoping to get to Indy and go to that Big Ten championship game, obviously a win is needed today. How do they do it?
Well, it's not going to change, Kev. Their recipe really hasn't changed at all. So what you do is you take a big Jonathan Taylor and you put him behind a big offensive line and you sprinkle a little Cephas on the top of it and then you take a little cone and throw a little bit of that. But Jonathan Taylor has to get to be the main meal and the main thing, and he is. And the last time they played, he ran for over 200 yards, coming off a 250-yard weekend last week. He is the key to this team, and you know what? If he's running well, it takes a lot of pressure off the defense. Their defense right now has been playing exceptionally well. And so what do they do well? They give you a lot of different looks. And so they give you things that you haven't seen before. And they'll give you a three down, two down. They'll bring different linebackers all over the place. You really have to be on top of your game if you're going to move the ball against his defense.
I feel a certain amount of pressure to continue your cooking analogy, because on the Nebraska side, they're without one of their main ingredients, and Wan'Dale Robinson puts a lot of pressure on the head chef, Adrian Martinez.
Yes, it does. And let me tell you something right now with Martinez. Martinez certainly is capable, but what slowed him down a little bit is he's just hesitated just a tad. Today, he's got to be decisive. He's got to let the ball get out of his hands. He's got to be decisive when he's going to take off and run the football. He has the capabilities. If he can do it, we'll have our game.
It's an injury-plagued Husker team, and with more on that, we welcome in the third member of our crew, Rick Pizzo.
Kevin, Scott Frost made no bones about it. Wan'Dale Robinson is the most versatile player on this team, the most dangerous weapon Nebraska has. They do not have him. His 40 catches, his 463 receiving yards, both school records for true freshmen. But Robinson is not the only notable player missing today for the Huskers. On the defensive side, starting nose guard Darian Daniels has been banged up all week, unable to go, did not dress. Carlos Davis, we just learned about 30 minutes ago, will also not dress. This for a Husker defense, which hasn't been very good with those two players, and now faces Jonathan Taylor, averaging 235 in his career against this team. Adrian Martinez did warm up, looked fine, as close to 100% as we've seen him in a long time. Scott Frost says without Robinson, they'll have to run Martinez more than they'd like, and he has to play better. Think about this, Kev. Martinez has not thrown a touchdown pass since Nebraska played Illinois on September the 21st.
Brody Belt is the deep man for the Huskers, who won the toss and have elected to receive. So the Husker offense is going to come on the field first, and we'll see if they're able to be a little more deliberate today without Wan'Dale Robinson, who has been arguably their most diverse weapon on offense this year. Zach Hintz kickoff, and Belt going to bring it out from 2 yards deep, trying to make a play early, and he's not going to. The young running back stacked up at the 14-yard line by Jalen Franklin, and Nebraska starting in less than ideal field position as Adrian Martinez makes his way onto the field. As Rick mentioned, the last passing touchdown 55 days ago. Now, some of those games he was not playing due to injury. But that's a long time for a team that's only thrown 8 touchdown passes in total this year. Martinez on first down. Good protection. Nobody open. Now he's going to run. And Martinez down at the 18-yard line. A pickup of 4 covered up by Caesar Williams. Nebraska playing behind an offensive line with a young center, Cameron Jurgens, who really struggled to start the season snapping the ball. Scott Frost said he's the one thing he likes about Cam Jurgens, he doesn't make the same mistake 2 weeks in a row. He continues to learn in his first year at the position. Second and 6. Quick toss. There's Shady Spielman, incomplete. Eric Burrell knocked it out of his hands.
It's an incomplete pass. Third down.
Kevin, that's the one guy that they have who can make a play right now. And that's J.D. Spielman. And every opportunity he has, he's got to be able to make. And so his first one, he flubs, sets up this third.
He had 209 yards receiving against Wisconsin a year ago. Mills on third down with a hold. Dedrick Mills into the secondary and run out of bounds across the 45 by Reggie Pearson.
Nice job on the left side of that offensive line. Hickson does a good job. You can see just everybody body on a body. They got him running laterally, and then they spread the thing open. Mills takes advantage of the big hole.
27 yards for Dedrick Mills on third down, and the Huskers move the chains. Only the 26th play that Wisconsin has given up this year of 20 or more yards. They don't give up a lot of big ones. Mills will try again, and this time runs into Chris Orr.
Full carry by number 26, Dedrick Mills.
Defensively for Wisconsin, they've got a change in the middle of the defensive line. Bryson Williams, the Lincoln native, is injured. He's here but not playing today. Keanu Benton gets the start in the middle of the line. But this defense, Matt, is all around these linebackers.
Yeah, it really is, and they're setting them up. But this defensive line does a really good job of eating up the blockers, and also when they start moving them, they make plays.
Mills will motion out on second down. Martinez, a design draw. And there's the notion of using his legs early.
Yeah, so what he's trying to do right there is just spread everybody out, eliminate the numbers in the box, and then you run at it. And it's simple. If you take the guy from the middle backer spot, once you get to that second level, you get a lot of running room.
Spielman in motion on third down.
So playing the zone. And they're going to blitz out of it. Nope. Backed out of it.
Martinez on the run. breaks a tackle, has the first down, and Adrian Martinez running confidently early.
And decisively, and that's the key. Remember at the top of the show, we told you, he's got to be decisive. Make a decision quickly. If it's not there, then take off. If it's there, let the ball rip right away. Well done by Martinez.
A little bit of tempo now. Nebraska's going to change this tempo up on and off throughout the day.
Tempo's important. Once your offense gets going, it limits what you can call defensively, and you can kind of put them in a position that you want.
Play clock winding down. Now it's 7. Bills upended by Reggie Pearson. If you're looking for the UMass Northwestern game, go to btn.com/gamefinder right now to see where you can find the game in your area. Martinez under pressure and Orr with the sack. That's number 10 for Chris Orr.
And he's a linebacker, and he leads their team in sacks. And the reason he does is because this is a pretty diverse. You can see him. He's right down here. And he doesn't get blocked. He better make this play. And the whole thing right there is you got to have the right angle. But they do this schematically. You don't know who's going to come. You have to account for the inside people. A lot of times you let the end man go. They did that there, and they paid for it.
Jim Leonard's done an excellent job as the defensive coordinator for this Wisconsin team. 3rd and 14. Martinez under pressure again, and he's caught from the backside. This time, Zach Bond got it.
There's a shot. Those two guys have played excellent football all season long. Bond has had a bunch of sacks. Orr has had a bunch of sacks. They're both very heady plays. He's up here on the top. This time, he's just going to run around the tackle. So he's got to get depth. You got to get your hands on him. And so he was beat after the second step. Instead of getting vertical, he turned his shoulders and tried to face him. And once you lose your hip position, you're dead.
Bond and Orr have combined this year, Matt, for 18 and a half sacks.
And Chris Orr would gladly tell you that he's in the league.
Yes, he would.
I love that kid.
Jack Dunn, the deep man. Huskers will try to pin the Badgers deep. Takes a little Badger hop and then a big Badger kick. Timeout on the field. Wisconsin's offense going to work next. 9:59 remaining in a scoreless ballgame in the first quarter. Alongside Matt Millen with Rick Pizzo on the field, I'm Kevin Kugler. Great to have you with us to start off your college football Saturday in Lincoln. Jack Cohn coming out to work at quarterback. Only Russell Wilson better in Wisconsin history as far as completion percentage. His career completion percentage, 69.7%. This year, 73% for Jack Cohn. From the 19-yard line on first down. Stocky and Taylor in the backfield in play action. Cohn to throw, goes short to the fullback Mason Stocky. Tackled down at the 26-yard line by Berry and Boodle. Stocky played well last week for these Badgers behind a good offensive line. Every one of those five guys, Matt, last week played all 74 snaps in the game. Second and 3 at the 26-yard line. First carry for Jonathan Taylor. He's got a hole and a first down, and he drags Cam Taylor-Britt to the 39-yard line before he's finally down.
So the first part of this run is all on the offensive line, and then the second level, you see Davis right there. Oh, he ended up getting put on his back, but I thought he had a good jump on it. But if you try to tackle this guy with arm tackles, or if you're not all out going in, you're not gonna fare very well.
No Darian Daniels for Nebraska this week. No Carlos Davis in that defensive line for the Huskers this week. Tough week not to have your full complement of defensive linemen. From the 39-yard line, Taylor up the middle, and Jonathan Taylor still on his feet to the 42, picks up 3. That Nebraska defense has certainly had its ups and downs throughout this season. But when you take guys like Darian Daniels and Carlos Davis out of the front, Matt, that's a big, big loss in a game like this.
And see, Kevin, this defense is predicated on the down three people eating up all the blockers, and the backers are the ones who should be making the plays. So this linebacker core, they've got to pick it up. Because I actually think this defensive line does their job fairly well. They don't have a pass rusher, however.
Quintez Cephas is the motion man. Groshek in the backfield next to Cohn. Groshek with the carry. And Groshek fights his way for the first down near midfield. Cam Taylor-Britt, the first man to get there.
So this is just going to be a case of just wearing. This is what Wisconsin does. They just line up and they just start grinding on you. And it's 3 yards here, 4 yards here. In the first quarter, maybe you're averaging like maybe 3 or 4 yards a carry. By the fourth quarter, that's when they start to break them.
They brought in a sixth offensive lineman, Tyler Beechin, as an extra blocker along the line. Cone on the roll. Nice grab and then dropped by Taylor out of bounds.
That's a live ball.
It's still live, and Nebraska's got it. JoJo Doman knocked it out, and it humped the sideline. Nobody went to get it, and the Huskers say they've got it. So do the officials.
I agree, that's the right call. That was a phenomenal catch, and he pulled it back in. And, well, let's see how it got out.
The ruling on the field was a completed catch, fumbled by Wisconsin, recovered by Nebraska. First down. Media, timeout.
Now watch this, that's a phenomenal catch. Now he tucks it away, and that's a great job of smacking it out. It never goes out.
Everybody stopped, and finally, somebody went to get it. A timeout, and it's Nebraska ball when we return. 7:15 remaining in the first quarter. We'll hear from Dean Blandino in a moment, but this is indeed a catch, a fumble, and a recovery by Nebraska. Every single player on the field stopped, and the Nebraska coaches let the Husker defense know to go get on the ball. Dedrick Mills to the 39, maybe the 40-yard line. Let's go to Dean Blandino. He's with us in our Fox studios in Los Angeles. Walk us through this, Dean.
Yeah, a lot of things to think about. Did Taylor catch it? He's going to control it, have the ball long enough. Now does the ball touch the sideline? Close, but doesn't touch the sideline, and then you get the clear recovery inbounds. The officials let it play out. They saw the line judge throw his beanbag. Great job all the way around.
Dean, thanks very much. I'm sure I've seen everybody stop like that before on the field as Martinez to the air, and he's short on that one in the direction of Cunnevine Noah. Jonathan Taylor, that's been the one Achilles heel that's cropped up on and off for Jonathan Taylor, Matt, in his career, is the fumble.
Yeah, when I speak to the scouts around the league and they start talking about Jonathan Taylor, they all love his running skills. They'd like to see him catch the ball a little bit better, but he has put the ball on the ground, and that's a concern.
A few weeks ago, had that big one at Illinois in the Illinois comeback for that huge win for the Illini. Third and 7 at the 40-yard line. Martinez, good protection again with time. Finds Spielman for the first down at the Badger 39.
He can thank his offensive line. Had a lot of time to be able to throw. He's just sat in the pocket and waited for Spielman to get over the top of the defender. That took a little time. The ball was right where it needed to be. Scott Frost, remember he said to us before the game, hey, we're going to have to dial up some of his numbers. We're going to have to get the ball in his hands and let him use his feet more, and they're doing just that. Martinez just runs with great instinct.
And a snap direct to Dedrick Mills, touchdown!
Mills with that full stride, Kevin, in the backfield before he ever hit the line. And a great haul, got to the second level, and he just turned it on. If we could get a camera up here, see Kevin has his balloons.
The balloon came into the booth. The wind is really blowing today, and Huskers fans released balloons on the first score. One of them popped right into the booth. 7-0 advantage for Nebraska. Quite a play call and good execution, Matt, by the Huskers.
No, it's great. I want you to watch. Look at these at full speed right there. Get to the second level, and you're not bringing them in six quick.
On fall Saturdays, see if red magically forms in Lincoln. For those who can't frequent the festivities, fear not, for word of good news is spread via the special telegram in the sky.
One of which ended up in our broadcast booth just a moment ago.
For a moment there, I thought it was your pom-poms, but no, yeah, those are still in your pockets.
The balloon flew right into the booth, hit the window, and now kicking into the wind, a short kickoff, Cruikshank from the 11-yard line. Cruikshank with a hole. Cruikshank stiff-arms the kicker, and down the sideline, a little shimmy shake, and he's going to take it to the house. Aaron Cruikshank with the answer for the Badgers.
Aaron Cruikshank.
When you get kickoffs, Kevin, most of the time they're well blocked, but then the kicker has to beat at least one guy. And here's his one guy. There's one, and now there's the angle that he had to beat, and a nice job of Cruikshank. Just that little hesitation, it got him to the top end, and his speed saved the day.
Aaron Cruikshank has really become a kickoff return weapon for this Badger team, and you saw it in full effect there as he brings it back 89 yards for the touchdown. And just like that, this game's even. Aaron Cruikshank was averaging over 24 yards per kickoff return before the 89-yarder. That average is going up. Let's take a look at today's Auto Owners Impact Players. Nebraska about to get the ball back, and J.D. Spielman's got to have an impact.
He has to, as long with Mills. You already saw Mills. He's running hard. And Zach Bond and Chris Shore, we talked about them in the first series. Both of them are excellent. But let me tell you something about Nebraska's impact players. None of those guys are any good if Adrian Martinez doesn't bring his A game, and it looks like it's here today.
He's the key. If you're joining us late, no Wan'Dale Robinson for Nebraska's offense, one of four finalists for the Horning Award, is the most versatile athlete in college football. Robinson banged up, not able to go today. So that takes a big weapon away from the Huskers. Badgers will kick off. After the 89-yard kickoff return, that kickoff through the end zone for the touchback as we head to Chicago and welcome in Mike Hall. He's got a T-Mobile studio update.
Hey, Kevin, Matt, let's update you. Indiana, Penn State. Ty Freifogel playing America's favorite game. Could I be more wide open? 38 yards for the score. We're knotted up in State College.
Well, that is America's favorite game. We've seen that play out in different ways here. A wide open kickoff return for Wisconsin to get even. And now Adrian Martinez back to work for the Huskers.
Kevin, the Wisconsin linebacking core really upset with itself after each of the last two Nebraska drives. Jack Sanborn explaining that he had fallen off Adrian Martinez when he saw the quarterback's eyes look downfield. The coaching staff telling the linebackers, no, if he beats us with his arms, so be it. You cannot let number two beat us with his legs.
Well, That's the hope for Nebraska, that he can indeed beat him with his legs today. Dedrick Mills doing some work with his legs so far. Huskers, Matt, already over 100 yards rushing against this Wisconsin defense.
Yeah, and they're doing it off the edges. When they run back to the inside, I tell you, there's a kid down there who I really like on the nose tackle. That's Kiana Benton, number 95. There's two freshmen playing against each other. They're going to see each other for the next few years. Both those kids are really good players. I really like what Benton looks like.
Jim Leonard told us this week his wrestling background gave him a chance right away from a leverage standpoint.
No, you're kidding.
Yeah, did you know wrestling season started a couple weeks ago?
I can't believe that.
Yeah.
That's unbelievable.
Matt loves wrestling. Second and 8, 43-yard line. Dedrick Mills again, a yard to the 44. Chris Orr leading the way for Wisconsin.
Let me show you this Keanu Benton. So he's a nose tackle right now. He's getting up. Now he stays his ground because he's not going to get beat. Now right down the line, and he gets in on the play. This kid plays with great leverage, has violence in his hands, which you don't see all the time. He's going to be a really good player.
Third and 7. Mills again with an opening. Mills with another first down. Nebraska is 4 of 5 on third down against a defense that only allows 21%.
Now here's Benton. He's getting on the backside shoulder. He's got to know he cannot do this. So he's learning on the job, okay? Once he gets past, that other guy gives him pressure. He's got to arm under that and control that gap. He went too far. They ran right behind him.
8 carries, 79 yards for Dedrick Mills, who has one 100-yard game as a Husker. That came against Northern Illinois. Martinez on the keep. And Martinez gets a couple to the 38-yard line. Rashad Wildgoose on the stop.
It's funny, Kev. I'm watching the freshman tonight and Benton in there, and let me tell you, the worst place to learn how to play that position is right there in the middle of the game. He's going to get hit a lot of different sides, a lot of different ways. He'll figure it out. He's smart, but it's tough sledding in there.
Wyatt Mazur in now at running back for Nebraska. Martinez will set up the screen to Mazur. Not a lot of blocking out there. That's all Wyatt Mazur. Any yardage he got there on a move to the 32 before Benton could get him. Weeknights, our football insiders go in-depth on all the hot topics around the Big Ten and talk with the people making headlines. Don't miss the big show weeknights on BTN and the Fox Sports app.
Going quick.
And Mazur with the carry, and the ball is out. Still loose on the field, and it's recovered by the Huskers. Short of the first down. Brendan Hymus, after about 9 hops, grabbed the football.
Yeah. Let's see if he's down when this comes out. Let's see, the ball's out. You know, that's a fumble completely. And then it's a scramble. And there's 1, 2, 3, and it pops all the way out the back end. Hymus, like you said, jumped on it. Game at the Hymus maneuver. A little bit different than the Heimlich.
It is. It's a little bit different. Yes. So Nebraska kind of in no man's land here, going into the win. Fourth down, they're going to go for it.
They should. They've had success.
Spielman in motion. Mills bouncing off one, can't get away from the second. Benton got him first, Rand finished him off.
He's a quick learner, like I said, Kevin. Benton disrupted the hole inside. Sometimes you get had, and sometimes you get him. Here he comes up top. Well done. Now got to wrap up. Then the rest of the guys are there for him. But Keanu Benton, that's a nice series. Good learning series, and he made some plays. Like that kid. Good wrestler, kid. He's a good wrestler. I think he was a state champ.
Yep. His wrestling background. In fact, he was a runner-up, man. His junior year. You're giving him the championship.
Forget it. Yeah. He's not that good.
From the 34 on first down on the sweep, Danny Davis with a blocker out in front. Davis a first down into Husker territory at the 49. Cam Taylor-Britt on the tackle. Let's take a look at today's Auto Owners Impact players when Wisconsin has the football.
Well, Jonathan Taylor, we talked about him, and you know, he's gonna get the ball. He's gonna get it a lot. Quintez Cephas is one guy who has big speed, can beat you down the field. Nelson's a kid I really like. He's got a great motor. He doesn't really know what's going on yet, but he'll figure it out. And Stille, the defensive end, he's been the most consistent guy they've had up there.
In the middle of the defensive line for the Huskers is true freshman Ty Robinson, highly touted recruit, getting his first action. Lost Jonathan Taylor there as he tried to pull him down, and Jackson finally wrestles him down at the 30-yard line, a pickup of 19 for Jonathan Taylor. That's Kevin, likely the final play of the quarter.
And that is vintage Jonathan Taylor right there. So he's a combination of, he's more power than anything, but he has great speed. But you can hang on him. He just keeps on moving the pile.
They do not have to snap it, but they will. And Taylor,
oh, nice.
Just lost his footing. Will Honus tripped him up at the 26-yard line. And that brings us to the end of quarter number one. Huskers running out onto the field trying to get two wins out of their next three to get to a bowl. But the Badgers using the big play in the return game to even it up. Perfect November day in Lincoln. Temperatures expected to top out right around 58 degrees as we welcome you back for the start of the second quarter. Wisconsin and Nebraska knotted up at 7 apiece, but the Badgers on the move, moving into the wind now as they go to work. Second and 6 at the Husker 26-yard line. Shifting into the eye with Stocky and Taylor behind Cone. And Taylor tripped up by Damian Daniels. Mohammed Berry there to finish him off, but no gain for Jonathan Taylor. Now, we are going to keep our eyes on Jonathan Taylor today. We're calling it the Herschelometer because, frankly, he's chasing Herschel Walker. Most career rush yards through a junior season. Nobody's ever done it better than the former Georgia running back Herschel Walker, who in the 80s set the standard. Nobody has accomplished that since. But Jonathan Taylor's got a shot today, and we're going to keep our eyes on Taylor's chase of history here in Lincoln. Third and 6 at the 26. Cone, with pressure coming, hit as he throws, incomplete. DiCaprio Boodle came with the pressure, Matt, and Cone couldn't complete it. It's fourth down.
Smart by Boodle. Smart what he did. Groshek had him. Watch it. Watch Groshek, 37. He goes to the outside. Boodle comes back to the underneath side and can't get. He actually uses his offensive tackle against him, and it sets up this fourth down.
And Wisconsin's been outstanding this year on fourth down. 9 for 11, tied for best in the Big Ten.
Going man.
Huskers bring pressure again. Cone throws over the middle. Cephas with the catch, and the spot gives him the first down just across the 20-yard line.
That is nicely done by Quintez Cephas. He knows exactly where the sticks are. He gets enough depth, makes the catch, and then tries to extend it, but it looks like he got the first down. See where he catches the ball? There's a first down right now. Now they push him back. He tries to extend it at the end, but I thought that was a good spot. Fisher was right on it.
So a first down just inside the Husker 20-yard line. Right. Ferguson and Sampson, the tight ends, on the right side of the line. That's Cruikshank motioning back. He gets the ball. And Cruikshank tripped up by his tight end, Jake Ferguson, who was upended and kind of got his legs tangled with Cruikshank.
Well, that's just a great play outside by 20. Look, right there. It's phenomenal. That's really hard to do.
Lamar Jackson
had to take on an offensive lineman. So usually what they do is they take out their knees, and he did, but had the wherewithal to still get up and get in on the play. That's a great play, Jackson.
Taylor on second and 6 leaps into the pile and is down to the 13.
Nice job by the defensive front up there. It's a big offensive line that they've been playing pretty good. This Wisconsin offensive line, they just get on you and they grind. They kind of just try to maul you. Drink, here we go. It's an inside joke. Daniels did a nice job holding the point.
There's Garrett Nelson on the field. Good look at Khalil Davis as well. Huskers rotating in as best they can to try to hold up against this Wisconsin attack, third and four. Taylor again, he's upended. Right around the ankles, Khalil Davis. We showed you before the snap, Khalil Davis, whose brother Carlos not playing today, and he makes the play. The field goal unit comes on now for Wisconsin.
That's a good play by Khalil Davis, and that's all on him. See, they gave him some movement. The inside of Moorman, he does a good job of taking the inside and then squaring his shoulders back up. Well done. I love good defense. I like defense better than offense.
Really?
It's hard to believe.
I know. I mean, what side of the ball did you play on all those years? Colin Larsh from 31 for the lead. And Larsh's kick is good, and Wisconsin up 10-7. 11:22 remaining in the first half in Lincoln. Take a look at today's Land Rover Conference news and notes. The road team in that Michigan-Michigan State series has won the last four. Chase Young back next week against Penn State. Final game of his suspension served today when the Buckeyes play Rutgers later on BTN. And Minnesota can clinch the Big Ten West with a win and a Wisconsin loss. So Gopher fans, big fans of the Huskers today, as is that guy, former Husker quarterback Eric Crouch, the 2001 Heisman Trophy winner. Eric, one of the legends of Nebraska football.
Boy, he had a phenomenal senior year. I mean, it was just all over the place.
He was great in his senior year. You look at a guy like Eric Crouch and you think, what, wouldn't he have been something in a Scott Frost offense?
He was something in the offense they had.
Frost the 25 and down to the 28. As we go to our Chicago studios, Mike Hall's got a T-Mobile studio update.
Hey, Kev, the Wildcats of Northwestern are desperate for some good news, and they just got some. Joe Gaziano with the field goal block on UMass, picked up by Chris Bergen, and he carries it all the way home. And just like that, the Cats were almost down 6-0, instead are up 7-3.
That is good news. Northwestern certainly needs some good news this season.
They better beat UMass.
Yeah, they're a prohibitive favorite in that game. Huskers with the football on first down. Martinez to throw. A lot of traffic, but it's Jack Stoll. And Stoll somehow breaks free of all that traffic. Down to midfield, and a flag down as Martinez got hit late.
Oh, Zach Bond got him on a delay. It was the TE, it looked like. Stunt on the top side, and Bond came clean. You can see him coming right around. Now he's one step, and I don't know about that.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense, number 56. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down, timeout for a defensive injury.
The defensive injury that Larry Smith, our referee, speaks of is Reggie Pearson. Still
also
down on the field.
Timeout.
And a timeout in Lincoln. Reggie Pearson headed to the sideline. Up and moving on his own, which is good. Next Saturday, BTN tailgate heads to Columbus. Dave, Howard, Jerry, and Michelle set the scene for the showdown between the Buckeyes and Nittany Lions. Get you ready for the entire day of action. BTN tailgate presented by T-Mobile. Next Saturday, 10 a.m. Eastern on BTN and the Fox Sports app. First and 10, Nebraska, after the 23-yard catch and the 15-yard penalty, a 38-yard play in all. Huskers with it at the 35 of the Badgers. High snap. Mills able to make something out of it to the 32. As we go to Chicago, Mike Hall's got a T-Mobile studio update.
Hey, Kevin, update on the Paul Bunyan Trophy. Michigan State driving. That's a 29-yard catch for Cody Wright. White, he's ruled down at the one. They pop it in on the next play, so the Spartans strike first. They're up 7-0.
Cody White's a real talent. Swing pass to Spielman. Got a couple of blocks. Spielman with a first down inside the 20 and down to the 18 of Wisconsin. 14 more for Nebraska as J.D. Spielman connects.
This looks like a different offense right now. This does not look like the last three games that I've watched on film. They are sharper. They are more up-tempo. And Martinez is on his game.
He was really off his game in that Purdue game, especially two weeks ago.
Well, the ball's coming out quickly. He's being decisive, which he needed to be.
Another high snap. He pulls it down. Mills breaking tackles. Sets for a second. Mills down inside the five. First and goal. Huskers at the two.
Who needs Wan'Dale Robinson when you got him running like that? Heck, he's Mills right now. Denton Mills is running as well as I've seen anybody run this season. He's running tough. He's running with speed. Great pad level. That's good stuff, Dedrick.
And rare missed tackles for Wisconsin defensively.
Well, he has something to do with that.
He certainly does. First and goal at the 2-yard line, and got a stoppage in play. Paul Chris calling a timeout to talk with his defense.
Kevin, some guys, when they're running the football, they know how to attack a defender. And you watch him, he has that. He attacks an edge. He doesn't, rarely does he take a guy right down the middle.
Dedrick Mills closing in on a 100-yard day already. And Dedrick Mills getting it done on the ground, up the middle, breaking tackles. And the Huskers looking for the lead when we return. Dedrick Mills, 12 carries, 97 yards in the first half against the nation's fifth best rushing defense, the Wisconsin Badgers, and Nebraska 2 yards away from taking the lead.
Kevin, if inside three, Jurgens the center, Dixon on one guard, and Wilson on the other side. Those three guys have been playing pretty darn well right now.
Martinez on the keep, touchdown, Nebraska.
Kev, I think he got his swagger back. No, he's got it. I mean, he's decisive. He's running with confidence. I just said to you in the commercial, like, where was this guy? Where was this the last few weeks? That's what you've been expecting. Andy Martinez has brought his A game.
Aaron Pickering's extra point is good, and Nebraska with a 14-10 lead. Adrian Martinez starting to feel a little good as the Huskers grab the edge. Nebraska back on top, 14-10, with 9:32 remaining in the second quarter. How'd they get there? With this Speedway scoring drive. Our scoring drive is brought to you by Speedway. And Adrian Martinez with a 2-yard rushing touchdown, capping the 5-play, 73-yard drive that took under 2 minutes to go those 73 yards. And the Huskers on top, 14-10. Impressive day so far for Nebraska offensively.
Very, very impressive for this offense, and in particular, Adrian Martinez. Well, Mills is no—he's no slouch. He's playing exceptionally well.
205 total yards for Nebraska, 97 for Wisconsin. Their touchdown coming on a kickoff return from this man, Aaron Cruikshank. Flag is down, and so is Cruikshank near the 25-yard line. Tripped up by Luke Reimer, and we'll wait and see about the flag. Badgers likely to back up.
So, Kevin, if you're a Wisconsin fan, you're thinking, all right, we got to get, how do we get back into a rhythm? You do the same
during
thing you've
the return,
always done.
Holding, receiving team number 30. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Back at the 14-yard line. Here's how the scoring has gone so far for Nebraska's Dedrick Mills, capping a drive that got them into the end zone after a Taylor fumble. Then on the ensuing kickoff, Cruikshank goes 89 yards. The kickoff return for the score. Huskers come back. And Adrian Martinez from 2 yards out into the end zone. And Nebraska with the 14-10 lead. Big plays have been a big staple for Nebraska today. Pryor in motion. Jonathan Taylor the carry. And Taylor gets a couple. But Nebraska's defense, despite Mathis and Carlos Davis and Darian Daniels, have held up pretty well so far.
No, they've done well. So the short term is never the problem. It's the long term with Wisconsin. It's how long can you keep on grinding, because they're used to it. And they're going to keep on pounding and pounding. That's why it's important that Nebraska gets a little bit of a lead So they have to get him out of that run game.
Nakia Watson, freshman running back who's flashed some good moments this year for the Badgers. Cone on the roll to Taylor on the sideline, slips one tackle, and down goes A.J. Taylor with a first down at the 28-yard line.
That's a nice job of catching the ball away from your body, just plucking it with your hands. When you see guys catch like that, you know they've got good hands. A lot of guys like to use their body and stuff like that, but you saw that when he just kind of plucked it right out of the air.
20th catch this season for A.J. Taylor. The number's down a little bit from where they were last year when he led the Badgers with over 500 yards receiving. It out. Quintez Cephas breaking tackles and down at the 40-yard line. Another first down and a gain of 12.
Cephas is their playmaker. That's the guy who's got the big speed. He's got top-end speed. He can take the top off of the coverage, but he can also do this, Kevin. He can also catch the short stuff and turn it into a big play. He's got big play capability, and that's what you have to have in every offense.
At 94 yards against Iowa last week, and nobody better on this team when you need a first down catch than Quintez Cephas. Watson on first down goes crowd surfing a bit to the 45-yard line.
Kev, there's one guy, he's just a freshman. I've been watching him on film, and he's just one of those guys, Garrett Nelson right there. He's one of those guys that has a motor that won't quit. He loves to play football. I mean, it just jumps off the film when you see it. He loves to be physical. He loves all the things about it. And he doesn't know exactly what he's doing yet, but when he figures it out, he's going to be a really good player.
Second and five of the 45. Here he comes, closing in on Cone. He gets rid of it to Taylor, and Taylor's got a first down, bouncing off tackles. Nebraska didn't wrap up, and A.J. Taylor is going to take it all the way for the touchdown.
Phenomenal effort by Taylor, and not Jonathan. You see what we're talking about. A.J. Taylor did a phenomenal job, Kevin, terrible job of tackling in the secondary, but he kept his balance in the middle of the field, and off he's gone.
It's a BTN standout presented by Auto Owners Insurance.
Right there, that's, who's that, Boodle? Yeah, he didn't, see, okay. This is what I'm talking about. The most important thing in a tackle is to get the guy on the ground. Doesn't matter if you hit him, doesn't matter if you have great form, he's got to be on the ground.
Seventeen-14, Wisconsin by three. 6:39 remaining in this first half. And now a word from our sponsor, Nationwide.
All right, Brad, once again, I have revolutionized the songwriting process.
Here we go.
I know I can't play an instrument, but this is my forte. Obviously, for auto insurance, we've got the wheel route.
Obviously.
Retirement, we're going with a long-term play.
Makes sense.
Pet insurance.
Wait, let me guess. Flea flicker.
Yes. How'd you know? I'm studying my playbook.
Yeah, actually.
Well, that one no flea flicker, let me tell you.
The longest pass play of the season for Wisconsin, 55 yards. As A.J. Taylor broke through one tackle and spun off the attempted tackle of DiCaprio Boodle.
There was a lot of good things that happened on that play. So they had a decent amount of pressure on him. Garrett Nelson did. The ball came out and was pinpointed exactly where it needed to be. Poor tackling, great balance, and a score.
This has been the game of big plays so far. And this kickoff, a good one, into the wind and into the end zone for the touchback. Let's check in downstairs with Rick Pizzo.
K
Kevin, as this Wisconsin defense takes the field, let's see if that touchdown gives them a little bit of energy. They've looked flat on the field, on the sideline. They typically give up, what, about 85 yards rushing a game. They've given up 140 already in this one. They don't seem to have a lot of confidence. The look, honestly, reminds me a lot of what we saw in the fourth quarter against Illinois. Offensively for Nebraska, meanwhile, a totally different scenario. Their offensive line brimming with confidence. At one point, the coaching staff talking about changing pace, going fast, going slow. One of the linemen said, it doesn't matter what speed we're going at. We are going to own these guys.
Confidence.
Yeah, it's a great observation, Rick, because when those big guys up front are feeling good, man, take advantage of them.
And look at the protection they provide here. But it's tipped at the line by Orr, and it's intercepted by Sanborn. And Sanborn down at the 21 of Nebraska.
Chris Orr again. Even when he doesn't make the play, he makes the play. Just got his hand up. Martinez had him wide open. Really good job of identifying him. Here's Chris. And he's eyeballing him. And he's eyeballing him the whole way. So watch him get his hands up. See? And they're putting him there for a reason. The reason he's there is to mirror the quarterback in case he takes off. In this case, he gets his hands up and does a great job of awareness. Sanborn takes advantage.
Second interception of the year for Sanborn, or with the deflection. And now that energy that Rick talked about, decidedly switching, because Wisconsin can add to the 17-14 lead off the Husker turnover. Danny Davis in motion. Taylor with the carry. Taylor breaking through down the sideline and tiptoes out of bounds, where it'll be first and goal Badgers.
Kevin, I'm thinking about that last play on the interception, and what they did with Chris Orr was they put him there as a spy on Martinez. So in case he takes off, he's going to break from the pack, and he's the guy responsible. And it worked both ways because it kept him in the pocket, and then when he threw, he was able to get a hand on. That's just good defense.
Pryor on the sweep. Pryor fighting his way to the goal line down at the one.
Good job of Ferguson out front there. Sophomore tight end number 84 getting a block, and Pryor does a good job. I don't know if he may have gotten in. He's mangled right there. But I don't know if he was down, Kev. Let's look at it. Knee's not down.
Now, his head may be down somewhere in that pile. There's his head on the turf. Yeah. One knee equals 2 feet. What's the head equal? Second down and goal from the one. Jonathan Taylor with the carry. Jonathan Taylor with the touchdown. 16th rushing touchdown this year for Jonathan Taylor. Overall, his 20th score. And the Badgers open up a 9-point lead.
But he really hasn't gotten on track yet. The turnover gives him the short field. Taylor turns it into points. Down in Georgia, Herschel's feeling pretty good about that number.
Exactly. 10 carries, 60 yards for Jonathan Taylor with the touchdown. And Wisconsin able to take advantage of the Husker turnover and turn it into a touchdown. 24-14. Jonathan Taylor telling everybody how he did it. Well, I got the ball, and then I ran in for a touchdown.
He was talking to John Settle, who did a lot of this stuff himself.
Jonathan Taylor's touchdown makes it 24-14 Badgers, and the chase continues for Jonathan Taylor, one of four backs over 5,000 career rushing yards through his junior season. Jonathan Taylor closing in on Herschel Walker, and, you know, if he doesn't get there today, Jonathan Taylor still has two more games in the regular season to get there. Seems like it's going to happen. As the kickoff will be fair caught and out to the 25-yard line. Next week, our BTN crew, Matt, Rick, me, the whole crew will be in Iowa City as the Red Hot Illini take on the Hawkeyes. Kickoff noon Eastern, presented by Speedway. Illinois, one of the really good stories in a league this year that has a lot of good stories. You know, Ohio State dominates the headlines, but the story of Illinois has become remarkable. What Minnesota has done is just captivating the nation right now. And let's not forget about Indiana and the growth that that program has had. From the 25-yard line on first down, Jack Stoll in motion. Here's Mills on the sweep. Mills, over 100 yards rushing on the day. He's got the first down to the 40-yard line, a pickup of 15 on the ground for the Husker junior.
Yeah, they've got this defense down, Kev. Whatever Wisconsin's given them, Nebraska has it. And so they're getting to the edge. They're running to the inside. They're having their way with his defense.
13 carries, 112 yards for Dedrick Mills. Play action. Martinez under some late heat. He'll throw this away. Good coverage downfield. Let's take a look at today's Discover Conference standings. Of course, Wisconsin would love to see Minnesota fall to Iowa. If they get a win here, that means they're only one game back, and those two teams meet at the end of the season. Nebraska hoping for two wins in their final three games to gain bowl eligibility. Talking with Scott Frost yesterday, and our producer, Bart, who I've been asked not to mention his last name.
Yeah, he's a fox.
Asked him about what it would mean to be bowl eligible. He said, you know, it's the 15 practices. Oh. Our young team, what a hit. Just an absolute stick from Zach Vaughn. Vaughn, all arriving at the same time, and give Wisconsin's linebacker the edge there.
Yeah, well, and they tried to block him, but Vaughn read it right away. It's a great read by him. See, and he beats the block to the outside. And just a good job getting to the ball where it's supposed to be, and a poor job of trying to get out there to block him.
Austin Allen was trying to get to him and didn't get there. Third down and 10. Huskers are 4 for 6 on third down today. And a timeout called from the sideline. That play clock was down to 1. A little bit of confusion. Scott Frost
Nebraska
wants to talk it over. We'll step aside for a quick 30-second timeout. 4:23 remaining, first half. Badgers 24, Nebraska 14. Husker turnover on their last drive led to a Wisconsin touchdown. And now Nebraska facing a third down and 10. Martinez off the timeout, alone in the backfield. Three-man rush for Wisconsin. Martinez with all day to throw, nobody open, and it's tipped out of bounds, incomplete. Noah Burks got a hand on it.
Burks had a chance for a pick right there.
He did.
They rushed 3, they dropped 8, no place to throw the football. And so it's a zone, Kevin, and so if you can buy time in a zone, you'll find a hole. And so he finally got pressure, and he was lucky that wasn't picked. Burks had a chance at it.
Trying to fit it into Cade Warner on the sideline there. And Nebraska will have to punt it away. Second punt today for the Huskers. Jack Dunn, the deep man for the Badgers. Short punt. Davis tripped up as he tried to turn the corner.
Good play.
Last drive for the Badgers started with the pick, and then with the short field, Jonathan Taylor went to work. Down the sidelines, Kendrick Pryor able to get moving on the end around, and then Taylor finishing it off with his 16th rushing touchdown of the year.
And so, Kevin, right now it's 24-14, is a 10-point lead. Now is the time when this Nebraska defense, they've got to stop them. They've got to get a stop here in this series. It doesn't have to be 3 and out, but they can't give up a score.
Back-to-back touchdown drives for the Badgers have sapped a little of the momentum the Huskers were enjoying up 14-10. And here's Taylor on first down. Breaks the tackle, breaks a second tackle, slips through. Almost slips through the tackle of Honus, who grabbed him on the ankle.
Kevin, that is vintage Jonathan Taylor right there. So it's a combination of speed and great feet and great balance. So he misses the first one, good power. Gets into the second one, great balance. Gets to the third one, makes a miss. Keeps on going, lowers his shoulder. I mean, he's just, that is what he is. And you look up and it's another first down. He's just, he's a talented guy.
76 yards, averaging 7 yards per carry for Taylor in the first half. Going to throw on first. Short toss. Kendrick Pryor with the catch, and Pryor with the first down. Picks up 12 to the 49 before Boodle and Barry can bring him down.
Nice job by Boodle. He's out there all by himself with nobody around. You better make that tackle. And this time, he does a nice job of wrapping his arms in the open field. Gabriel Boodle's a good player. I mean, he's got good coverage skills. He can run. He's not afraid to tackle. He throws himself in there. Every now and then, though, you know, you just don't wrap up. That cost him last time.
Sitting more at safety the last couple of weeks for Nebraska as they've shuffled things up in the secondary. Here's Taylor, gaping hole up the middle, and Mo Berry got him around the ankles at the 42-yard line. 9-yard pickup for Jonathan Taylor.
He just caught him at the end, or he could have been gone. Mo Berry just redirects and just catches that lower leg. All they're trying to do is get you to start to run, Kevin. They'll start getting you to run lateral, and then you don't even have to block him. All you have to do is push him, and he'll come back, cut back, and you're off to the races.
It was a huge concern when they played Michigan State. Defensive coordinator Mike Tressel told us that week, nobody else does what this Badger team does anymore. And on a normal week, you only have 3 days to get ready. Nakia Watson slithers through for the first down to the 39.
Now, my guess, Jonathan Taylor's gone next year. He'll go to the NFL. This kid right here, 14, Watson, that kid's a good player. He probably doesn't even know how good he's going to be yet. But he's got great balance. He catches the ball well out of the backfield. He has some make and miss in him. He's one of those guys like a little jitterbug sometimes, but he can still run with power.
Huskers continue to rotate deep on that defensive line. Casey Rogers, the redshirt freshman who missed last year with a torn labrum, out there playing for Nebraska along the line. As Cone over the middle, that's incomplete. Trying to hit A.J. Taylor, and that'll bring up second down. Coming up at halftime, Mike Hall, Coach Glenn Mason, and Joshua Perry will get you caught up on week 12 with the Michigan-Michigan State update, plus an update on Indiana and Penn State. Coming up on the Reese's Peanut Butter Cups halftime report.
Keep your eyes on 87.
Cone, look in that direction, and it's incomplete.
Well defended. Well defended, they did a good job. They slanted this way. Coverage jumped it quick, had nowhere to go as it sets up this third down.
Ben Stille got a hand on this pass as well to keep it from getting to Quintez Cephas. You see it here.
Yeah, nicely done by Stille.
Here's Groshek on the short toss. Nice cutback. And Groshek with a first down.
Bad tackle. He had a chance to get him and stop it short. But he ended up, Groshek just ran right through him.
Timeout taken by Wisconsin. 1:16 remaining in the half. New set of downs as the Badgers are on the move. We'll step aside for 30 seconds. Paul Chris using one of his two remaining timeouts a moment ago, stopping the clock with 1:16 to play in this first half. Badgers 24, Nebraska 14, and Wisconsin trying to stretch this lead going into the locker room. And remember, Wisconsin, because Nebraska won the toss and took the football, Wisconsin has the ball to start the second half as well. A chance to really open up a big advantage here.
Nebraska needs a big stop right here. They need a big play.
With time, looking to the sideline for Cephas. He was well covered by Braxton Clark. Redshirt freshman Braxton Clark out of Orlando, Florida. Got his full four-game complement last year in his redshirt year, now second and 10.
You know, a few weeks back against Michigan State, I watched Jack Cohn and I thought, you know what, this kid's got it. He's got a real chance, but he hasn't really taken from that. He needs to keep on building off of what he had.
Here's Taylor. Big hole again for Jonathan Taylor. Taylor in first stride. And Taylor down to the 10-yard line of Nebraska. 17-yard run. Will Honus with the tackle.
Now he watched that free safety. He watched him come from about 10 yards away, and he just eyeballed him. Wait till he got there. Just kind of made a miss and picked up 4 yards.
First and goal at the 10-yard line. Here's Taylor. Chased down from behind by Berry at the 6-yard line.
They do. Right now, they look like the Wisconsin team that we've always watched. They took the last 4 minutes and just ground it down to this last 30 seconds.
Taylor over 100 yards in this first half. Second and goal. Cohn off play action on the slant for Cephas. Coverage from Lamar Jackson. No flags, and it's third and goal.
I like that matchup. Cephas and Lamar Jackson. Both of them have about the same size. Jackson has good length. And that was really well played. See, didn't go for anything. Oh, nice pivot. And he came right back in on top of him. That's good defense. Cephas got some pretty good quicks, too.
Drive, and it's third and goal. Cohn incomplete. Beater on the coverage of A.J. Taylor.
Yeah, that's completely on Cohn. He missed it completely. Threw it way behind him. He had him open. It was a leverage. It was a leverage route. All he has to do is get between the quarterback and the defender. Watch him. He gets to the inside right there. That's perfect. But the ball's thrown behind him. If he throws it out in front of him, he's got a chance.
So Wisconsin will have to settle for a field goal try. Colin Larsh coming on for this 24-yard attempt he hit from 31 earlier. And Larsh now 2 for 2 on the day. 27-14 Wisconsin as we step aside for 30 seconds. Let's take a look at the SoFi academic ambitions, and today we focus on Husker defensive end Ben Stille, a 3.39 GPA in nutrition health sciences, academic all-district, twice academic all-Big Ten, nominated for the AFCA Good Works team. Ben Stille in that Husker defense trying to get things going in the second half. It has not been easy pickings as Wisconsin has started to get things rolling a little bit in the late stages of this second quarter.
Yeah, that's why they needed to have that stop right there, Kevin, on that drive. You know, they're going to get the ball back here in the third quarter, and that's going to be another one. They're going to have to stop them and give up no points in that opening drive and then get something finally up on the board.
Short kickoff. A little bobble of the ball loose, and Nebraska fortunate to cover that one up. Zach Weinmaster was nearly a disaster for the Huskers at the 11-yard line.
Where's Johnny Rogers when you need him?
Look at that. One more time.
You know, Kev, I was walking the halls here before the game and just looking at all the great players that Nebraska's had through the years.
Tons.
I saw, you know, old Raider there, Bob Brown, great Hall of Fame player. And you watch Johnny Rogers, I saw Jerry Taggy, I saw Rich Glover, that brings back a lot of good players. Great players have played here.
Huskers would like to dip into that well and find a few more. As they'll go into the locker room down 27-14. to the Wisconsin Badgers. Nebraska led 14-10, but Wisconsin scored 17 unanswered to close the half and up 27-14 at halftime. We'll step aside, Mike Hall and the gang on the Reese's Peanut Butter Cups halftime report after these messages on BTN.
So Minnesota, they have everything right where they wanted it to be. They got the last three games. If they can win this thing out, they're in tremendous shape. But they're going to have a tough time getting through all this, okay? And so it's not going to be an easy road. And then you still have everybody vying for position. And really, Wisconsin right now, they've got a shot. And they're keeping their eye on Minnesota. But all they have to do is take care of this business first before they ever move on to anything else. And if you're going to do that, the one thing they're going to have to do is come out and score early. And see if Rick has something to say about that. I know he always does.
You know what? Let's go to Rick Pizzo.
Well, Paul Christ is pleased with the score, but not necessarily with the way his defense is playing. Said way too many big running plays given up, specifically on third down, for a defense that prides itself in getting off the field on third down. Need to be much better in the second half. Scott Frost is pleased with his team's effort. Said the guys that we have out there are giving it all they have, but we are so shorthanded, we can't make mistakes and give points away. Felt like the kick return and the tip pass, which led to a short Wisconsin touchdown drive, was just giving away 14 points.
Big hit on Cruikshank, who bounces off the tackle. Aaron Cruikshank staying on his feet despite the smack, and out of bounds across the 20-yard line. It was Damian Jackson, who got a black shirt this week, that provided the initial pop right there on Aaron Cruikshank. He's 26 years old. He's a Navy SEAL. He joined the Navy out of high school. And Rick Pizzo, even at the end of that play.
He's got in on the tackle.
Rick Pizzo is not a Navy SEAL.
Hey, I think I should get credited, maybe not for a full tackle, but I at least get the assist there, right?
Absolutely. I'm marking it down on my chart right now.
Big day today for Pizzo with a half a tackle. From the 21-yard line, first down. On the sweep, Danny Davis trying to get it going, and he's yanked out of bounds by Alex Davis.
All right, big series right here. If this Nebraska defense is going to have to be able to hold this right here, they can't give up any points. They've got to get the ball back, and they've got to give themselves a shot to get back in this thing. He got away with one there, Kev.
Looked like it. Wandered in the horse collar territory, but no
call.
And good night from Lincoln. That makes the horse sound. It's time to leave. Pressure coming. Cohen has to leave the pocket and throw that one away.
Smart.
Ben Stilling with a good rush there, man.
Well done by Stilling. A good job in coverage downfield. Nobody to go to. And then the smart move by Cohen. Just get rid of the ball, but it sets up this third down. Big third down right here. Talk big third down, just talk about Quintez Cephas, number 87. That's who they like to get the ball to. Or they'll throw a screen. This is a big screen team, Ken.
Nebraska knows that as well. Eric Chenander told us yesterday that's the one thing they focus on the most when they get him in third and long. One thing to know it, another thing to stop it. Here's the screen to Taylor, and Nebraska does stop it. DeAndre Thomas with the tackle, and a three and out pitched at a critical time by the Blackshirts.
Nicely done by the sophomore out of Mustang, Oklahoma. Read it exceptionally well. You can see him, number 97, right down here on your screen. They just disengage, and part of screens is having a sense and feel for it. And that's exactly what he did. He felt it. Not like he was getting blocked the right way, so you just stop and pick off and find him. Nicely done.
So the defense gets the stop it needed. What will Nebraska's offense be able to do? J.D. Spielman with the fair catch at the 43-yard line. Let's check in with the Aflac Duck for the Aflac Trivia Quiz. Thank you, Duck. Which Big Ten team does Jonathan Taylor have the highest career rushing yards per game average against? Matt Millen? Are you guessing?
Millen, Penn State. I'll go with I'll go with Nebraska.
It's been a sound effect kind of game for Matt Millen in this third quarter. Buzzers and horses.
You don't know the half of it.
I don't want to either. Martinez, the swing pass to Spielman. Spielman looking for blockers, and Spielman making a play with a first down to the Wisconsin 45. Eric Burrell on the tackle 12 yards later.
You know, Kev, as long as J.D. Spielman has been here with Nebraska, he always makes plays. He always comes up with catches, critical times. He always moves the ball, moves the chains. He's gotten better as his years have gone on. Just a junior, got another year. That guy's been money for them.
First and 10 at the 45 of Wisconsin. Dedrick Mills, who had over 100 yards rushing in the first half. He was in the backfield as Martinez throws. Kind of on Noah with the catch. And Noah out of bounds inside the 25.
That's on Martinez. Excellent job by Martinez. Now as he's winding his way across, it takes time to develop that route. And the time was bought with Martinez's legs as he rolled to the left side, was able to find him. Well done.
They've got a whistle and a stoppage in play. Wisconsin's using its second defensive timeout of the ball game. Their first timeout in the second
Wisconsin
half. We'll take a timeout
the
with them as we step aside
in Lincoln. Media. Timeout.
Here in Lincoln, Nebraska trying to do something no one's been able to do this year against Wisconsin. Score points on the opening possession of the second half for that team. Badgers have not allowed a point to be scored on any opening drive, first or second half this year. Mills out of the backfield on first down. Good protection for Martinez. Now it breaks down. Martinez in trouble, and Martinez is sacked the way back near the 45 by Zach Bond. Loss of 21.
And that was all Bond, because he had a guy to throw it to, and he starts to roll. But I want you to watch at the end of this what Bond does. See, he knows he can't take off, but he gets his hand up right there. See, he was about to throw it, and he got his hand up, and he was able to bring him down with the other hand. Well done by Zach Bond.
Second down and 30. Running out of time now, and he'll just have to run out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Picks up five. Vaughn and Williams chasing him out.
They get a couple of smattering of boos out there, but he had nothing to do. So he's able to buy time with his feet and get out to the right side. But if you look down the field, he's sitting in zone. And what happens in zones, if you can find the hole, you sit in the hole. But the longer it takes, what they call plaster. And the defenders who are in the zone will lock up on the man who's in it.
So now it leaves Nebraska with a very uncomfortable third and 25. Martinez throwing short to Noah. Kind of on Noah to the 25 and down to the 24. So what this does give you is an option now to get 3 points out of this possession.
Which is exactly what you wanted to do. So you know you're not going to get all 25 back, but you are going to be able to get back some position, field position, to be able to give yourself a chance for a field goal.
Barrett Pickering missed a good chunk of this season with injury, the first 7 games, and it really hurt Nebraska. They were as inconsistent as could be in the kicking department. This from 41, he's got the wind at his back. Tough snap to handle, gets the snap down, and the kick just slides by the left upright, no good.
Not a good snap. Not a good snap, and you wonder if it messed with their timing.
He's just missed. Skidding past the upright, keeps the score 27-14. Time for what you've been waiting for, the answer to our Aflac trivia quiz.
Aflac.
Which Big Ten team does Jonathan Taylor have the highest career rushing yards per game average against? Now, he's rushed for over 200 yards twice against Nebraska, but it's not Nebraska, it's Purdue. 270 yards, the average for Jonathan Taylor against the Boilermakers. Taylor on first down, and Taylor to the 30-yard line before Ben Stille can bring him down, give him six. Jonathan Taylor, there are the numbers against Big Ten opponents. Purdue, 270 yards. Nebraska, 235. And Iowa, after a 250-yard performance last week, that average up to 173.3. More for Jonathan Taylor.
Jonathan Taylor's not afraid to run in a crowd, and he's also has very good patience. Watch this. He's going to stand there. Now he knows he's behind some people, and he just keeps his feet up moving. And he just, yeah, that's rare. When you get a guy who's in, he's not afraid to get in all the dirt and all the mud and everything, and oh, you can't do that on a
on the field turf.
On a field turf, but
the Herschelometer, he's chasing
40 yards back.
For the most yards ever in college football through a junior season. Jonathan Taylor just tripped up. He almost got to Herschel on that carry. But Braxton Clark said, we need more Herschelometer on this broadcast.
I think he thought he saw all that green, and I think he was hopeful. You know, just between you and me, Kevin.
Yeah.
I texted Herschel.
You did?
Yeah, I did. And so he probably won't see it, but I texted him. I want to see what he had to say about this. Let's see if he gets back to us.
He might be watching UMass Northwestern.
I doubt it.
Second and one at the 44-yard line. Taylor fighting through an opening to the 39 for the first down. Incidentally, when you say just between you and me on a national television broadcast, other people can hear it.
No, they can't.
Yeah, it's true. It's many times that what we say is actually broadcast out with the pictures.
I can't believe it.
I know.
People would listen to this?
Oh, no, not willingly. Batteries are dead in the remote.
Got it.
Yeah.
Got it.
Don't know where the mute button is. Done in motion. Nakia Watson, the running back, with the carry, and Watson down to the 34-yard line. Okay. O'Berry with the tackle for Nebraska.
You know, Kev, honestly, when Watson's in, sometimes you can't tell the difference between he and Taylor. This kid's going to be good. This kid's got, all he doesn't have is a lot of carries. Other than that, very similar.
Well, you know, I mean, listed both at 5'11". Taylor listed at 219, Watson at 229. You're right. The future is still bright for Wisconsin in the post-Jonathan Taylor era. They seem to always have somebody next up at that running back spot.
Yeah, they do.
There's Watson again. On second down into the arms of Will Honus at the 32. The whistles blew before that pile moved, and the rugby scrum will not count.
You know, actually, I don't know if I'm a big fan of that. They changed that rule a few years back where you can keep on pushing, your lineman can push the ball carrier prior to the push. Remember that one out there with Reggie Bush? Prior to that, you could, if you push him, it was illegal. Now, heck, they'll push him for 5 yards.
Third and three here for Wisconsin. Just 1 for 5 on third down today. Cone, short toss, Kendrick Pryor, first down out of bounds at the Husker 20.
Smart, really smart. So they take the, looked like it was Jonathan Taylor. They had him offset in the, and they ran a route with him to clear everything out. You're going to watch him. He's going to come out here and go this way. And then they bring him back underneath to the cleared area, and it's an easy catch. It's just smart, basic football, fundamental stuff, clearing areas and filling it with another receiver.
Give to Crookshank. Goes a little sideways to find extra room and is down near the 10 in the arms of Will Honus.
He's mad at himself because he had an opportunity to cut back one more time and he had a shot for the end zone. I'll tell you, that Crookshank kid, he's quick. He's got some good make it miss in him. Kind of jitterbuggy, and he's got great speed.
We saw it on that kickoff return for a touchdown. He went 89 yards after the Huskers scored their first score. Shank again in motion. Taylor the carry this time. Look at that opening for Jonathan Taylor. Taylor into the end zone for the touchdown. A gaping hole, and Taylor knew right where to go.
Yeah, that left side of that offensive line did a nice job. And they got some good people there. Van Lanen, the offensive tackle, Mormon 68, Biotis 61. That's just good football. I mean, everybody on somebody. Oh, see Biotis just bury Mulberry, yeah. There's too many Mo's in there.
Oh, Curly, where have you gone? Only Mo's. 34-14, Wisconsin with 4:50 remaining in the third. And Jonathan Taylor with this touchdown run, chasing Herschel just 12 yards away from history. Football on BTN is brought to you by Auto Owners Insurance for all your home, auto, business, and life insurance needs. And by Discover, the official credit card of the Big Ten Conference. Those scenes from earlier, the two-chopper flyover before the game, they were low. It was really cool. That's Matt Millen's legs dangling out of that chopper.
No. I was on one of them one time over in Afghanistan. I will never do it again.
Jonathan Taylor waiting for his chance at history. We showed you before the break as he chases Herschel Walker's record for the most rushing yards in college football history through your junior season.
Right.
Herschel Walker, I think in the games amount, did it in fewer games because, of course, there were fewer games played back then. But Jonathan Taylor is going to blow it out of the water with probably three or four games left in this Wisconsin season. Tonight, don't miss Big Ten basketball on BTN, presented by Jeep as Indiana hosts Troy. Then Monday, number 3 Michigan State and number 16 Ohio State are in action during a doubleheader. See it all right here on BTN and the Fox Sports app. Best college basketball game of this young season was the other night when Michigan State and Seton Hall played. That was a tussle. Get the chance to see the Spartans again this week on BTN. Michigan State won that game against Seton Hall as Dedrick Mills back to work on the ground for the Huskers. They have found something today with Dedrick Mills as Reggie Pearson trips him up after the 20-yard gain. We'll go to Chicago. Mike Hall has the T-Mobile studio update.
Kevin, the update on the 112th meeting between in-state rivals Michigan and Michigan State. It's all maize and blue right now after this touchdown from Donovan Peoples-Jones.
All right, Mike, thanks very much. Dedrick Mills, another chunk play, gets 11 more. Chris Orr on the stop. And Dedrick Mills over 120 yards.
So you're asking why this is happening, and here's why. So they'll leave one play, one player unblocked. They block part of the line down, and then they widen everybody. And that just expands the defense. So they cut the backside off, expand, leave one guy unblocked, and that's what you get. Backers have to fill that.
It's his best game as a Husker, 133 yards now as Martinez off play action. With time, still the tight end over the left side for the first down for Nebraska down to the 23.
Kevin, that's exactly right there. That's what Adrian Martinez has to do. So he surveyed, went through the whole thing, saw his guy, and let it rip. And that's exactly, when he's decisive, he's better.
Huskers back to pace. A little urgency for Nebraska now, down 34-14. Adrian Martinez has not had a passing touchdown since September 21st, only 8 this year for Nebraska. Martinez trying to change that now. Spielman does! Touchdown, Nebraska!
Good protection, good route, great play call. Martinez, as soon as he saw it, he let it go. That's just good football right there.
And Nebraska not done yet. Wisconsin had grabbed the momentum, but a quick 91-second touchdown drive puts Nebraska back on the board. And Adrian Martinez, 5 for 5 in the second half, including this touchdown pass to J.D. Spielman.
You're going to notice the first thing, there's nobody around him, so he had a lot of time to throw. And then Spielman got across, looked like on a crossing route. The ball was right there, and Spielman happy for it all.
Adrian Martinez, his first touchdown pass since September 21st. 8 of his 9 completions have gone for 10 yards or more today. Some big plays for this Husker offense to keep him hanging around in this game.
Best I've seen him play all year.
Now a little short pooch kick. And it's going to bounce. That ball is a live ball. It is loose on the field, and Wisconsin covers it up. A break for the Badgers as John Chanel was able to secure it before it took one wild hop. Let's go back to the touchdown, the pass from Martinez to Spielman.
Yeah, speaking of Wild, watch Wilder right here. He's going to get manned up one-on-one, and here's the fatal mistake he makes. He gets right down the middle. He gave Spielman a two-way go. You never do that. You give him one way to go, and you make him take that way so you can defend it. And Spielman just gave a little juke to the outside, and he was toast.
On the defensive line now, Nebraska brings in Keem Green, the transfer from Highland Community College, who is redshirting this year. Jonathan Taylor on first down, upended a low tackle by Lamar Jackson.
Well, we're going to get a heavy dose right now of Jonathan Taylor. We were talking about the recipe and how it works at the beginning of the game. Let me tell you something. Chef Rudolph, the offensive coordinator, Joe Rudolph, yeah, he's gonna be a big old serving of Jonathan Taylor right now.
And there's the Herschelometer. We got to show it to you because it could end here. A 6-yard carry, and he is the all-time leading rusher through a junior season in the history of college football. Taylor not going to get there to break the Herschelometer, but get there for the first down before JoJo Doman makes the stop.
Officials timeout for a defensive helmet off.
Now Jonathan Taylor will head to the sidelines, ensuring that the Herschelometer gets at least one more airing today on BTN. And there it is. He is 1 from tying, 2 from taking the lead. Call your kids, gather the grandparents, get around the TV. The next time he carries the ball, this could be college football history.
You mean like one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind?
It's similar to being on the moon,
okay,
I believe.
Got it.
Nikhil Watson into the arms of Will Honus, and Honus wins that battle as Watson's down at the 34.
Nicely done by Honus. Good job with the line of scrimmage. Good job by that defensive front. They play a lot of two-gap, which you hear that term thrown around a lot. Really, essentially what it is your defensive lineman basically having to handle two gaps, one on each side of them, and then your linebackers can run free.
Finn Anderson in on the defensive line for Nebraska now. They are really bringing in some depth today. Cole with protection, and it's knocked away at the last moment from Jake Ferguson, and here comes a flag. Eric Lee was on the coverage, and that flag came soaring in from the back.
Now we haven't seen much of Ferguson.
Pass interference.
That's good coverage.
Defense.
Yeah, he has him around the waist. That's, they're going to call that every time.
First down, a spot and foul.
It's that right arm that they called the pass interference for.
Yeah, they're going to look.
Correction, number six.
In today's football, that's getting called every time. Back in the day, that was called how you cheat. You grab that lower.
It's about 85 or 86,000 people in here. I'm getting about 2,000 Badger fans.
Yeah.
About 85,000 people who are wishing it was back in the days when you used to cheat like that.
Oh, they still do.
Oh, yeah. Just didn't want to get caught. First Husker penalty of the day. What's been a clean game, penalty-wise, on both sides. I say that, and here's back-to-back penalties and a delay of game.
Delay of game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Kev, you know, just watching Jack Cohn, he's not throwing the ball like he did. I wonder if something's wrong, you know. And this is just me. This is just me watching him. After watching him on film and stuff, it doesn't look like he's as crisp with his throwing motion as he has been.
First and 15, Garrett Groshek. Not much there, giving two to the 42. DeAndre Thomas with the tackle.
So you got him behind the chains, second down. This is a big series right here for the Huskers. They want to get back in this thing. They've got to be able to get off on this series.
Makes the catch, and Pryor knocked out near the 49-yard line. Lamar Jackson with the extra impetus to nudge him out. And now a big third down coming up for both of these teams.
I like Lamar Jackson. I think Lamar Jackson's played pretty good. Now's the time you're going to need a big play. You got to get a rush. If you don't get the rush, you got to have great coverage. And this is where Cephas becomes the guy. They like Cephas here, and they like Ferguson here on third downs.
And they're going to let this crowd cheer itself out for the moment. And they're not snapping it until the fourth quarter begins in Lincoln. A third down and 7 for Wisconsin when the fourth quarter begins with the Badgers up 34-21. Jonathan Taylor making a run at history, 2 yards away from breaking Herschel Walker's FBS record. Start of the fourth quarter. Wisconsin needs to keep winning. They need to see Minnesota lose a game in the next couple of weeks. The West Division Championship would come down to the final game. For Nebraska, 2 wins in their final 3 games. They can go bowling. The fourth quarter begins with a critical 3rd and 7 for Wisconsin.
Jonathan Taylor in.
Ferguson in motion. Pressure coming. Cohn in trouble. Gets away from Dolman. Cohn buying time. Finds Cephas, and Cephas short of the first down at the Husker 48.
Oh, Dolman does a great job. He would have been a phenomenal job if he gets a sack, but he forced the pressure, and he was able to make this thing be hurried up, and he threw it short, set up a fourth down.
So the Huskers get the stop they wanted defensively, and the Badgers will punt them deep and try to play the field position game here. Spielman, the deep man.
Good kick.
And it goes out of bounds. Huskers pinned deep in their own end. They'll start at the 4 as we go to Chicago. Mike Hall with a T-Mobile studio update.
Hi, Kevin and Matt. The latest from Indiana and Penn State. It's a 6-point game, and then Journey Brown busts it up the middle for a 35-yard touchdown. Penn State's now up 13 points halfway through the third.
Big play for Journey Brown and
good
for Penn State there.
Penn State's an interesting team. It's a really young team. Their best football is going to be next year.
That Indiana program, T. tip of the cap to Tom Allen and that staff.
Tom Allen's done a phenomenal job. He really has.
First and 10 at the 4-yard line. Spielman motioning out of the backfield. Martinez will keep. Martinez, a little zigzag cut. And Adrian Martinez with blockers. Martinez down just shy of midfield.
Caesar Williams, Kev, going at 21. He does a great job of keeping people off of him and being able to put himself in a position to make that tackle, or Martinez is gone.
Yeah, he had Kunavainoa in front of him trying to block him, and he wouldn't let himself become engaged.
Sideline interference, Nebraska sideline. That's a 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. Still first down.
Okay, so sideline interference is a very real thing, okay? They're just going to pay the price for it. What it is you have to keep that area, all that white area, and there's another marked area that the coaches can be in. But that has to stay clear, because the officials have to be able to have access to be able to run up and down that sideline. And a lot of times when there's a big play, guys walk out into that area, they knock officials down, and that's when you get a flag.
Yeah, you hear guys talk about the get back guy all the time on the sideline.
Yeah, he's a real guy.
Mills on first down. It's twisted around. Diedrich Mills breaking tackles again. Still on his feet, staying in bounds inside the 30-yard line.
This guy's putting on a show today, Kevin. Diedrich Mills has played big all game long, refusing to go down, and great balance, and just keeps it moving. That's just fantastic. His upper body got too much of a lean and pulled him out.
43 yards on the run for Mills. Martinez to the air, to the sideline, where Austin Allen makes the catch. Out of bounds inside the Badger 20, and Nebraska knocking on the door early fourth quarter.
Kevin, two things happened today for this Nebraska team. Number one is Mills. They have a real run game, and the running game has opened up this whole offense, and Martinez has been decisive.
16 carries, 187 yards for Diedrich Mills against a defense in Wisconsin that allows on average 84 yards on the ground per game. Spielman in motion. Martinez, the option pitch to Mazur. And Wyatt Mazur run out by Rashad Wild Goose. Well defended by Wisconsin.
Yeah, Wild Goose is another one of those. Wild Goose is a good football player. He can play corner. He can play safety. He understands angles. He saw right there, he took away the inside. You're going to give him one way to go, and that's it. And then you make the play. Well defended by Wild Goose. The Goose.
Brock Bando now playing left tackle for Nebraska, and a direct snap to Wyatt Mazur. They ran that play for a touchdown with Diedrich Mills. This time Wisconsin able to stop him at the 18-yard line. Tyler Johnson, the first man there, and it brings up fourth down.
Yeah, the difference between Mazur and Mills is when you saw Mills get it, he was at full speed with that second step.
So you're down 34-21, 13-point difference. It's two scores whether you kick a field goal or not, so Nebraska's going to go.
They're spreading things out. Keep your eyes on the quarterback's feet. They know it, too. As if they put a spy on him.
Martinez going to try to run, going to try to get through Zach Bond, and he's not going to do it. Bond stayed right there, Matt, and didn't leave the quarterback.
That's what you have to do, and so that's what they did. So somebody's assigned to the quarterback, because you know you're spread out. He has an opportunity to beat you with his feet. They did not allow him to do it. To take a look, and you look in the back here, and you see there's nobody back there. So that's called an empty set. And so you see no linebackers back here. And so what they do is they take Zach Bond and they fold him back inside, and he is to spy the quarterback because they don't want his feet beating the defense. Bond did it perfectly, was patient, and made the tackle. That's a big play. That's as good as a sack for Bond.
Well, that's what the coaches told they were concerned about the most was Martinez let him beat him with the arm, not with the feet. Here's Jonathan Taylor. Taylor fighting for yardage, and he's down at the 19-yard line in the arms of Mo Berry.
Looks like he got his 2 yards.
And Jonathan Taylor is now officially the most prolific rusher in the history of college football through his junior year, and he's still got the rest of this game and 2 more in the regular season. Jonathan Taylor is having himself some sort of career. What a talented running back, and congratulations to Jonathan Taylor. When you supplant Herschel Walker from any record, you're doing something.
He probably doesn't even know it.
Get on the YouTube and watch Herschel Walker as Cohen off play action finds his tight end Jake Ferguson, and Ferguson with a first down to the 33. Markell Dismuke with the tackle.
Been a quiet day for Ferguson, and I think he's really busted out this year. This is a player that they can rely on quite a bit. His hands are good. He's developing as a blocker, getting better. This is going to be a good tight end in the next couple of years.
In the building where his dad played football and his grandpa played football, both Nebraska football players, but Jake Ferguson making his name now at the school where his grandfather Barry Alvarez established himself as a Wisconsin legend. Jonathan Taylor, adding to the record, tackled by Garrett Nelson at the 49-yard line. The Big Ten Championship game presented by Discover is less than 1 month away. Badgers are hoping they're there. Be sure to tune in December 7th on Fox. They'll need a little help. That help could come today from the Iowa Hawkeyes. Badgers, if they win this game, become huge Hawkeye fans. They've got Purdue next week before they take on Minnesota to close that season. Down carry for Taylor, and Taylor finding some running room again. Look at Taylor dragging Huskers once more inside the 35 to the 33, and he had an iron grip on that football with both arms.
Yeah, he's well aware that they'll be trying to pull that thing out. Jonathan Taylor's, look at him, he's just holding that thing like it's a football.
Like it's the most valuable thing he's got right now. And for the third straight year, Matt, Jonathan Taylor has rushed for over 200 yards against Nebraska. He's on the bench right now. Nakia Watson relieving Jonathan Taylor. First down at the Husker 33. Watson, again, with a lot of room to roam at the 25-yard line. He is stopped. How often do you see it, Matt? Third and fourth quarter, those holes that were small in the first half become bigger and bigger.
That's what we were talking about, Kev, in the beginning. And so here it comes. And so those holes, because you just get worn down, you get tired, you don't get off the block as quick. You know, you're seeing things that you that you saw early and you were able to react, and now you're just not quite as quick off of things.
Typical Wisconsin drive, sixth play, clock continuing to run, chewing up yardage on the ground. Here's Watson again, and Nakia Watson with another first down to the Nebraska 19. And this has been the formula for Wisconsin, Matt. Your defense gets a stop, the offense comes back and just grinds something out.
Yeah, this is what linemen love. Yeah, they love to just line up and come off the ball. And this isn't any zone stuff. They're not taking lateral steps. They're coming right off the ball in a man scheme or a gap scheme, and they're just Ben Lane up top and Moorman and Biotis, Erdman and Bruss. They love this stuff.
On first down, Nakia Watson running behind his fullback Mason Stocky to the 14-yard line where he gets 5.
So the difference for a defensive player, Kevin, and stuff like this, is instead of coming off the ball attacking, you get a little bit too high because you start to get tired. And then you lose the leverage game, and they just, all of a sudden, you're on your heels and you're 2 yards beyond the line of scrimmage.
Second been 5 for Taylor. And Jonathan Taylor at the 13 is stopped. So now third down, Huskers trying to hold the Badgers to a field goal, which would still keep it within the realm of a two-score game. That would make it 37-21. You'd need two touchdowns and 2 two-point conversions to tie, but it does keep it within the discussion. First time they've hit third down on this drive. Third and two. Cone to Cephas, a little too tall, and it's fourth down. You surprised that they went to the air after the dominance they'd shown up front on that drive, Matt?
Yeah, and they loaded the box a little bit, and they had man-to-man on the outside, so I could kind of understand why he tried to hit him. Cephas is one of those guys who's your big play guy.
30-yard try for Colin Larsh, who's 2 for 2 today. And now 3 for 3. 37-21. 5:25 to go in the fourth in Lincoln. Football on BTN is brought to you by State Farm. Talk to an agent today. Well, we have cameras everywhere. That's what it looks like to be in the chopper on the flyover. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, you know it's not? See the guy's hand right there? That's kind of scary. That means he's right out by the door.
I wonder if it's your hand, it's scary. From where I am right now, it's fine. Those guys, man.
I'm not good with heights.
We're not exactly on the ground here in this press box.
That's a good point. Yeah, that's a good point.
Don't look out the window. Jonathan Taylor leading the way for the Badgers on that 10-play, 72-yard drive. Taylor, 204 yards rushing today. We got a chance to have two 200-yard rushers in this game. Dedrick Mills is at 187 entering this drive.
They got to score quick, so they're going to have to try to probably put the ball in the air a little bit more. That's kind of Jonathan Taylor. That was kind of a quiet 200-yard game.
It kind of snuck up on you a little bit.
Did.
It didn't have in it a lot of giant plays.
Exactly.
There's a lot of 10, 12, 15-yard chunks, but not the 50 or 60-yarder. And that kickoff way through the end zone for the touchback. Jonathan Taylor's longest run today, 19 yards, but he had enough of them to get to 204. Now let's take a look at the house they built by Rocket Mortgage by Quicken Loans. And this is what Nebraska is missing today. You know, it's not been a bad day for Nebraska offensively. Just imagine if Wan'Dale Robinson had been able to go. These are the numbers he's put up. Only Amon Green, DeMornay Pearsonell, and Amir Abdullah had more all-purpose yards as a freshman than Wan'Dale Robinson has this year. Unable to go today, Dedrick Mills has rushed for 187 yards. Adrian Martinez going to have to tuck and run on first down out to the 31. There's Wan'Dale Robinson. Boy, the Huskers certainly are thrilled to get the former Mr. Football out of the state of Kentucky, the consensus top player in the state his final year.
He is. He's exciting. He's a big play capability. Guys are hard to find.
Martinez on the keep with blocking out in front. Mike Williams was out there blocking on the edge as Madison Cohn chases him out of bounds at the 43.
Kevin, to me, the difference in this offense today has been the play of Adrian Martinez. We said at the start of the game that he had to be decisive, and he's done just that all game long. He has been sharp with his reads. The ball's been coming out well, and he's running exceptionally well. That's opened this offense up.
14 carries, 95 yards today for Martinez. He'll sling it over the middle, and that one floated on him over the head of J.D. Spielman as we check in with Rick Pizzo.
Kevin, Jack Sanborn doesn't get the same attention as fellow linebackers Chris Orr or Zach Baum, but he's a terrific player. Had the chance to speak with him this week. He acknowledged Wisconsin needs help. So I said, does that mean you guys are big Iowa fans this week? Shook his head and said, nah, those teams are both our rivals. We have to root against both those guys. There is one matchup he's rooting for, Wisconsin-Oregon in the Rose Bowl. Why? His dad, Paul, played for Oregon in the 80s. Died on March 22nd, 2005, 12 years later to the day. Jack made his commitment to play football at Wisconsin and says playing Oregon in the Rose Bowl would be a family dream come true.
Oh, that's a great story, Rick. And it certainly would be a dream come true as Martinez will get outside the pocket and just throw it away.
Smart play. Smart play and live for another down. This is as good as I've seen Martinez play. This looks like last year's Martinez.
Certainly the movement better. The bye came at a very good time, and Scott told us that yesterday. The bye came at an excellent time for Adrian from a healing up standpoint. He's still got the brace on that left knee that was injured a few weeks ago. But it's a lighter brace, and you can tell it really hasn't hampered his ability to run the football today. Third and 10 at the 43. And a flag comes in, some movement up front.
False start. Offense, number 37. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Wyatt Mazur was split out wide and left a little early. Now he will leave the ball game. Nope, he's going to stay in, going over the other sideline. Never mind, he'll stay.
Never mind.
Never mind. You don't leave. Stick around. Third and 15. Martinez over the middle finds Wyatt Mazur. Good thing he didn't leave. He's got the first down at the 42.
Again, it's the legs of Martinez buying some time. When he moves, the zone's open.
42. Two touchdowns and 2 2-point conversions needed for Nebraska to tie this game with 4 minutes to go. Martinez, pressure comes. Martinez able to outrun the pressure, and he'll throw this one away.
Smart again. And bought some time. This is exactly what they needed. They needed to be able to have him have some mobility and get the mobility that he had back. So what it does is just gives him a chance. And so defensively, if you're playing this kind of a team, and so you have to account for his feet, but then you have to be able to lock up on these receivers as well.
Second and 10 at the 42-yard line of Wisconsin. Austin Allen was the man in motion. Another high snap. Martinez with time. Pressure comes late, and he is slammed to the turf by Tyler Johnson.
That's tough, Kev. They only did a three-man route that time, and he was looking for the single receiver on the top side, which was manned up all the way. That's tough sledding when you're only, it's a, basically essentially a one receiver route.
Third down and 15. Pressure coming again. Sanborn gets there.
Flag is down here.
On the sideline, near side. It's fourth down depending on this flag, and we'll see.
Offside. Defense, number 17, lined up in a neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Dante Burt with the penalty.
Yeah, and he's down here.
So the Huskers get another shot on third down. This third and 10. Martinez. Moving to buy time. Noah is open, and Noah's got it at the Badger 5. First and goal, Nebraska.
Better throw, he'd have scored. But a great play. Bought it with his feet yet again. And Noah came from the other side of the field. That's a long crossing route. That takes time to develop.
First and goal at the five. Dedrick Mills not going to get there. Noah Burks, the first to grab him at the four. Clock running, 2:43 and counting to go in the fourth. Two touchdowns, two 2-point conversions to tie. And Nebraska's going to have to pick things up here. Cade Warner to the top of the screen. Martinez on the keep. Cut down at the 5-yard line by Reggie Pearson.
They better be mindful of the clock.
Because and a timeout used by Nebraska.
Right thing to do.
We'll step aside. We'll take a quick 30-second timeout for football in a moment. I like to envision Mike Hall wearing either the corn hat or the cheese hat when he and Mace and Joshua Perry are in the studio.
Nah, he'd be a cheese head.
He would be?
Nah, yeah. I mean, when you think of him, Mike, yeah. Look, yeah, cheese head fits him.
Does Mace have to wear the corn cob?
Nah, corn cob, I'm not a fan of the corn cob.
Wow. It's a tradition unlike any other.
Nah,
finding a fan in the stands wearing the corn cob hat.
I might have to just wear the cheese.
Third and goal at the 5. Martinez with pressure coming, and he throws this one over the middle in the direction of Spielman. But make no mistake, he was trying to avoid Zach Bond, who was right in his face.
Good decision by him. Yep. And he was getting pressure, and Spielman was there, but he saved it for another day. Now you got fourth down. It's a big play right here,
obviously. Fourth and goal from the 5.
Trying to spread him out again. They're going to put somebody on him on his feet. Let's see if it's who it is, Sanborn or one of those guys.
Pressure comes. They set up the inside screen to Mazur, and Mazur stopped short at the 1. Reggie Pearson saves the touchdown. And saves the score for the Badgers.
It's a heck of a tackle, Kevin. You have to make it.
Ruling on the field is running short of the goal line. First down.
Cuts up to the inside. That's just a good tackle. Excellent tackle. Got him to the ground. Pearson does a great job of wrapping up. Well done.
And so now Wisconsin takes over at the 1. 2:11 to go in this ball game, and the Badgers about to go to 8-2. And I know what Jack Sanborn told Rick Pizzo, that they root against both of those teams, but they'll probably lean a little bit towards Iowa in the Iowa-Minnesota showdown later. First down carry for Mason Stocky, and he gets to the 5-yard line. Huskers with 493 yards total offense. That's the most allowed by Wisconsin in any game this season.
Kevin, this Nebraska team right here, I mean, they don't have a lot of bullets, but they played a good football game. Two big plays killed them in this game. The tip pass, it turned into an interception, gave them the short field, and then the kickoff return. But they played this team pretty even the whole game. I think Scott Frost does a good job. I think Scott Frost has a good direction where they're going here with this team. He just needs more bullets.
Well, the Nebraska administration gave a big vote of confidence to the direction this program's going with the 2-year contract extension that Scott Frost got earlier today. Quick timeout by Nebraska, 30 seconds, step away for us on BTN. 37-21 Wisconsin, 1:23 remaining in the fourth. Scott Frost's Huskers close it in, unfortunately for them, on getting to the point where they have to win out to make a bowl game. Maryland and Iowa, the final two for Nebraska. And on the end around, it's Danny Davis, and Davis with a lot of room down the sideline, and Davis stepping out of bounds, not where he wanted to go. Will Honus with the tackle, but it's a first down, and that will do it. Let's take a look at today's Duluth Trading Company's hardest working player, and that's Jonathan Taylor. 3 straight years he's rushed for over 200 yards against Nebraska.
You know, rarely do you say this, but that was the quietest 200 yards I've seen. And he did it consistently all game long, just wore them down like we talked about at the start of the game. And here he is at the end of the game, and 200 yards again.
He tied an FBS record, excluding bowl games, shared with Marcus Allen, Ricky Williams, and Ron Dayne as far as 200-yard games, 11 in his career. That's remarkable.
Yeah, that's, you don't get to see these guys very often. When you do, you got to appreciate them. And Jonathan Taylor is as good a person as he is a player.
Ohio State and Rutgers coming up next on BTN, the number two team in the land. The Ohio State Buckeyes continuing their push towards a Big Ten championship game appearance. Of course, a big date next week with the Penn State Nittany Lions for Ohio State as the Badgers take a final knee, and that will wrap up a Wisconsin victory. It was a battle today. Nebraska's offense created some problems for Paul Chryst's defense, but at the end of the day, too much Jonathan Taylor, too much Wisconsin. They get the win 37-21 over the Huskers. Adrian Martinez, a little healthier than he has been. 220 yards passing and 89 yards rushing today for Martinez. There are better days to come in Lincoln, Nebraska for this Husker football program, Matt. For Wisconsin, they just continue to chug forward towards a date with Minnesota, which they hope will be for a Big Ten West title at the end of the year. Let's go downstairs to Rick Pisa.
Paul, more than 480 total yards. What did you like about your team's offensive performance this afternoon?
Well, I thought, you know, some guys stepped up and made big plays, and, you know, we're able to answer scores with scores and just kept playing, you know, and obviously this team got enough points to win this game, and it's always, you always appreciate that, and it's never easy, and you never want to take it for granted, and proud of this group that way.
On the flip side, Nebraska gains almost 500. Yeah. Any concerns leaving this game defensively that need to be addressed?
Well, yeah, I mean, no, you know, we're not going to play Nebraska again, but certainly they did a heck of a job of running the ball and making plays, especially on third down, and we're going to look at some things that we've got to get better at. But today, this team found a way to win, and for that, I'm grateful.
Paul, I imagine you'll go root for Iowa right now. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon.
I'm going to go enjoy this one. Thank you.
Thanks, Paul.
That'll do it for Memorial Stadium as the Wisconsin Badgers get the 37-21 win over the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Coming up, it's a Big Ten game break. Mike and the gang will get you caught up with all the scores and highlights from around the Big Ten. Now, for Matt Millen, Rick Pizzo, and Dean Blandino, I'm Kevin Kugler saying so long from Lincoln, Nebraska.